Hello, viewer. How are you doing? My name is Violet Bitty, convener of Real Talk Show, hosted by Violet Bitty. So, in this particular show, we host dazzling change makers from across the African continent who are doing amazing projects that are impacting lives. So, today, we are joined by a change maker, and his name is Crispin Okello from Child Space Organization. So, Karibu Crispin Okello to the studio. Kindly introduce yourself and let the viewer get to know more about you. And yeah, let's start.
Wow, thank you very much, Violet, for this opportunity. Yes, my name is Crispin Okello. I am the founder and the director of Child Space Organization here in Nairobi. Background of Child Space Organization, this is an organization that was actually founded in the year 2016, but got registered in the year 2018 as a community-based organization. So Child Space Organization, it is actually registered here in Nairobi or in Kenya, and the formation of Child Space Organization was propelled by the dire need to intervene and support the children, youth and parents, teachers, and everybody else in the community with when various support emerged that many girls and young school going is that and when asked, they were not able to fear anything except HIV and AIDS, and that was a concern, and that's why Child Space Organization was actually started. So it is a children's program, and we are focusing on teenage pregnancy, prevention of it of teenage pregnancy, and of course the drugs and substance abuse, violence against children, okay, which we actually I will talk about it recently with we in collaboration with the government and of course other players like UNICEF. We were able to participate in the launch of the VSE, and we have some programs that I will also mention here to help us achieve all those that mission, our vision, especially our vision. We have a program called Parent Plus. Why Parent Plus? A parent plus the child, plus this adolescent, plus this teenager. So this is a program that ensures that the parents are empowered, and they consider the best interventions, and we have the best well-researched programs for them to empower them, to give them the opportunity to understand this teenager. Because it is at this stage, if you ask even you, Violet, if you can remember, in your teenage life, that you had some difficulties, you know, that's when you are at loggerhead with the parents.
We've lost you, Crispin.
You know, again, adult, and you are able to grow up and pass that teenagehood. Eh? So many of parents are giving up at that age of adolescent, and that's why all the children are being protected. But again, when they reach at the age that they are supposed to be making, you know, they have that's the teenage is the age where the identity crisis is happening a lot. They want some freedom, they want to be understood, they want so many things, but all at once. So if not guided by this empowered young or well, empowered parent or a significant adult, then this is where we lose it. Many have lost hope in the adolescents, and they bluntly say, I'm no longer in control of this person, this child, so you can do whatever you want. And actually, they are saying these kind of words in front of these children, and the ch child can confidently confirm that they are now on their own. My parents cannot control me, I am on my own, and that's where we lose it. So, child space specifically, as much as we respond to other children from the age 8 to actually 17, our program focuses from age 8 years to 17 years old children, but we majorly emphasize this program, parents program, for the parents with the either children about to get into teenagehood or those who are parenting the teenagers. So that is for the parents plus.
We've lost you.
Oh, I lost it a bit, but we went a little bit low. We need to have children who are not upstairs, who are smart in terms of their behaviors. You look at them and you see a smart child. So we are saying this is a smart children club in terms of behavior, in terms of the academics. Like I remember when we started this program, it was launched in March 2016 at Babadogo Primary School, where we started this. And many of the children enrolled in this program with the support of the teachers who we had trained, the patrons of the club. And the administration and the entire board supported this program. And the club has been so far so good, because all those children who were candidates in the 2019 years, all of them who are part of our program, you can confirm this with the head teacher of Babadogo Primary School. All of them passed their KCP, Kenya Certificate of Primary Education, with good marks, very, very good marks, and they were all called into very good schools. Because when a child is disciplined, has good values, is able to focus, has support, you know, and from home and in school, all children can perform really well. Even though they may not perform as in optimum level.
Lost you again. Viewer, this is internet issues.
Okay, mental, emotional and emotional support from the support system they are having. So we are saying this program, we never knew it will get to this, but when we reached after 6 months, because this is a consistent program, we have so many programs in this country, but our uniqueness is we are consistent. We work with these children from month one to the sixth month, where now they graduate. We have so many manuals that we are using. So you move from this phase and we move to the next phase. And if you go to our website, you can see www.childspecialorganization.org. You will see under our gallery there are program. There was a graduation that we did last year for the first lot, and we graduated 100 children that graduated to the next level. Some of them are those that I'm saying went or transitioned to high school, and we now have a program for high school, because when we started it was just for those who are in primary school, and now we have a program for those who are in high school whose program only ran during the school holidays. And for that reason in this August this program has seen us partner with so many people. Like, for example, we have networks of, you know, protecting the children, like keeping the children safe, keeping children safe in the UK, where I've also been allocated slot as a guest speaker in. Next month, the safeguard, to just share with the globe how to respond to the children holistically. So it is a consistent program. We don't just do it. Run away.
Crispy, your internet is having issues.
Just networking. I can see this, but I really do not know exactly what to do, because it's from one source. So allow me to just continue. I know it will give you some problems with editing. However, I was saying, I was saying that it is very important that we work with it. We just don't come and say we are. I'm not attacking motivational speakers, but people come in the life of the children and they say, we are motivating the children. Yes, after motivating them, where are you? These children have a lot of problems. I mean, they need somebody to talk to them. Like yesterday, I remember when you were in our club, because even now at two, we are there. You are talking with these children, and some feel they need this specialized attention. All right? They need this specialized attention. They need you after this. But this does not happen in normal clubs, in other clubs, where they just come, do the activity, and run away. As we have the counselors who can respond to them, we have the people who, the social workers who visit them even at home. Yesterday is the day we were doing the ID cards. After last month, the parents signed that I will support my children in this process for the next 1 year. You know, 1 year can be so much. Even right now, people are crying for 4 months, and we have a boom in teenage pregnancies and many other social vices. So you can imagine a whole year, if a parent decides to work with their children, this is a commitment that they have done and that they have made. And the teachers have also made the commitment. The children have also made that commitment that I will stay away from drugs. I will stay away from premarital sex. I will stay away from violence. And they're saying it, and we are training them. And yesterday we are giving them even the skills on how to respond to basic skills on first aid, basic skills. So we are giving this, we are saying we are a holistic, and actually, our motto says committed to holistic child development, meaning we are not giving a one intervention and runaway thing. We are giving them things and skills that they can also use when they are at home, where in schools, when they're with their peers. And because the teenagers tend to understand and believe their peers most, That's why the distraction happens, where the deviance, child delinquencies, and everything takes place there. We are equipping these teenagers. And there's a campaign that we started called Teens for Teens. If you go to our YouTube channel, you'll find this one there, Teens for Teens. And they're speaking to their, because of COVID-19, they're speaking, using this platform to reach out to the young people, because a few of them are able to access the internet and the YouTube and to that. So that is for the team, for the Smart Children Club. And in the Smart Children Club, there are some other sub clubs within. So first they meet for 1 hour, where we give them the mentorship, where we talk about decision-making skills, communication skills, many other. It's a kind of life skills, health, or comprehensive skill training, and it's gradual. Before COVID-19, we used to meet every single Saturday with these children from 2 to 5 in the evening, and this is now, and we can say COVID-19 gave us another opportunity where we tried online, and we've partnered with the Kenya Red Cross. We have done so many programs that runs every weekend. That is on Saturdays. You can check on our platform there. Because they realize we're doing something really good. So we partnered, and we're doing those online programs with them. And we've also talked about issues to do with gender-based violence, using the same platform with the children. Gender-based violence, sexual SGBVs. We've talked about non-violent intervention, interaction, importance of dialogues in families, and we are getting lots of feedback. By the way, we were to meet these parents to give us feedback, but yesterday is when we gave them the forms where they're going to sign, rather to tell us how it is, how is it working, what is the behavior of the child, because we also give them the manuals and the work that they do with the children on a weekly basis. We get some feedback, and that was not possible when we were hit hard with this coronavirus. And so I said we partnered with the Keeping Children Safe, who are actually supporting us technically in terms of fine tuning our policies. If you go to the Keeping Children Safe UK, you'll find us there, and we are trying to do this together. And we are in Kenya here. We are also trying to partner with a few people. Like I mentioned, FEDA Kenya, we're also having, in Sweden, we have Smart International, which is actually deeply rooted into contact concept, where they realize that what we're doing is, for the past 14 months, actually this is the 15th month with this club, is actually an amazing and unique. And they're saying, Crispin, with your team, I think we can come on board and try to maybe issue you with the manual that we use here for prevention science. I am a trained person with Universal UPC Corps by the Colombo, and of course the NACADA, partnered with so many other people, ISAP Kenya. We have been trained on universal prevention curriculum. This is a science-based intervention for prevention of drugs. And so when we unleash this slowly together with the support of NACADA, the other day we were reviewing, we're helping NACADA to review the documents or the manuals that are supposed to be given to us and the children from age 6 to age 18, yes. And we did this again online. Our children participated really well, and we gave them feedback, and they said, Crispin and the team, Child Space, that is awesome. So we are trying to do this so that when everybody else is crying about parents are not there, teachers, I don't know what, we can in our own small way do this. We volunteer to do these things. Nobody is giving us funds to do this kind of stuff, but our team members, qualified members, actually, we are working with the young people from University of Nairobi, from Masinde Muliro, and the rest. So this program, Smart Children Club, is a club that we can say is a community-owned program, because we are no longer having only children from Babadogo Primary. We have children from, I don't know, Ngunyumu. You know, these schools around Korogocho and around where we work now. And the center is where now is Babadogo, which are they've given us their hall, actually. We congratulate and appreciate so much Babadogo Primary School for giving us the space, and for our area chief for allowing us to sit with these children, of course, observing social distances, for those who have given us masks, for those who have given the children some food. If you look at our page, I mean, it's everybody seeing Crispin and the team. They are doing a good job, and they're just coming on board and doing whatever they do on that day, and they move forward. So we have other programs that are also running, but this one got actually stopped because of COVID-19. We have a program called trainings and capacity building. This is where now we meet the teachers and the parents. Actually, the teachers are trained on how to implement this, the life skills and for the children in school, and the parents are trained on how to handle them. All right. Now this one is just general capacity building.
Wow.
And then the next program, we also have what we call safeguarding and child protection. Safeguarding and child protection. This child space organization is known for active advocacy and implementation of safeguarding programs and child protection. For this reason, we are actively training. We are members of the Nairobi Child Protection Team. This is a network bringing together all the children, all the organizations working with the children in this country, rather in Nairobi. And we are the people. We have even, I think the last year or this year, I'm not so certain about that, maybe I check. We conducted a training for the team members, for the members of the network, on how to best prevent teenage pregnancy. What are the best ways to do this? Okay, we build our capacities on that. So we are members of the Nairobi Child Protection Team, and in the same platform, we are also members of the National Council for Children Services, where we are also we participate in many national things. Like I mentioned about the Violence Against Children policy and a document that just was released in July. On July 16th, 2020, you can check that one online. A very good document, together with UNICEF, where the it's growing up. When I was growing up,
Before you proceed, you are talking about collaborating with the UNICEF before yes. Internet ikapotea. Yeah. So well, kindly,
no, I picked that. Yeah. That. We participated online on a campaign that actually a report that was launched on 16th of July this year in 2020 by UNICEF, and of course collaboration with the government, Children Ministry. And we are active members on the children issues at the national level. And that's why I'm saying, when it comes to the issue of the Day of the African Child, we at the county level and the national level and the down here, we are actually doing this. We participate and we contribute, we give views, and of course, some maybe little resources that we can provide. For example, when we are coming up together, planning and execution, all those things, it was really awesome. This year's Day of African Child was really great, even though it was also unique because we did it online. So we are we are doing that. And we are also working so hard, very, very hard with other small organizations like us down here to ensure that the children are getting the services. For instance, if a child is fire, we never fire. Yeah, and so forth and so on. So those that's the capacity, and then we have the skills-based health education. Skills-based health education. This program is a program that is implemented in schools. We've worked with both schools down here, primary to high school. We have worked with so many high schools, especially in Kisumu County. I don't know Kisumu High, Kisumu what, Kisumu Girls. I don't name them. These schools, and this program actually seeks to ensure that prevention of drugs and substance abuse and multi-social vices is given a good intervention. Then the application of life skills and health education, in particular life skills, on areas such as teenage pregnancy, HIV and AIDS, reproductive health, gender-based violence, drugs and substance abuse, is becoming increasingly widespread, as you can see. So this program is to focus on their behavior, because all these are behavioral connected issues. If a child understands that I am who I am because of what I really do, what I think, what I watch, how I respond to things. So this is equipping them with the skills to just have this critical thinking and be able to be realistic, you know, in the process of doing so. So skills-based health education is being implemented with the support, and that's where after training the teacher, we are very fair schools. Yeah. So that's one of the many programs that we do. Of course, now another program we developed is TMEP, Teenage Mothers Empowerment Program. Now this has not really kickstarted. We pray it will not, because teenage mothers. This is what you remember. We are advocating for prevention of teenage pregnancies. So these teenage mothers, it's just in case a teenager falls, you know, becomes pregnant, then it should be able to take care of that. Because again, you can't save everyone. Eh? You can't save everyone, and we should not run away either from them when they need that help. Because many people, young people, get pregnant through many ways, through many reasons, and so when they become pregnant, this teenage mothers empowerment program should be in a position to respond. The only one girl that we responded to was last year, right here in Babadogo, and she's actually went back to school in Form 4. A very brilliant young girl. If you ask the head teacher, the principal of Babadogo Secondary School will tell you that Crispin really worked with this girl until she delivered the baby, and she was taken back to school. Yeah. And many other things that we're actually doing. So, and we have tried to do this in a small way, but in a bigger way, process. Okay, yeah, especially monetary. They get we're going to this for this training, we are going, Childspace is offering I don't know what. As what we can offer, and we've been offering, is simply the trainings for these children, the trainings and support for this and the psychosocial support for these for our target population, and they really appreciated. How I pray that maybe one of these days you can actually interview one or two of our parents. We can randomly choose. You can tell me this, so that you hear from, or even that head teach, all those teachers that we've worked with, because they keep on telling me, in Childspace, you've done so much amazing job. But you see, they're telling me, they're not telling any. I'm like, I want this process. Where is the weak point that we can adjust?
So, what challenges are you facing as a Childspace organization?
Like I mentioned before, The challenges are numerous, Violet. The challenges are numerous. Number one, not many people believes that you can work with just in-kind support to deliver. For example, when you are trying to, when you get a link to maybe write for a grant, and they need this, have you ever handled this amount of money? Yeah, who has supported you before? Who are your funders? If you have zero, you have not been funded before, they're like, you cannot manage their fund, nobody's willing to come and support you. These are, in fact, we are here to challenge the donors, that it is high time you start, you know, even you as a donor, there was your day one, your first day of, you know, experience that you donated something, and just what guided you is this was this trust for that person. You can't authenticate everything, but you can authenticate the passion, the vision, the commitment, because people get money, I know, and people get a lot of resources and they misuse them. But if this individual or this organization has been able to achieve so much, by the way, the other day we got a call from the government, from the ministry, from the children department, Nairobi County, were asking us, how many teenagers do you have who are pregnant within your program? I said, no. How many? I said, we have zero. In that school that you have, I said, zero. And they were like, how are you able to achieve this zero when other people, when the country is lamenting about the rise and the spike of the teenage pregnancies? I said, because of our the uniqueness of our program. That is exactly what you need to know. And they're like, can we share this information? I said, yes. If you give me a platform, you can share, because our intention is to ensure that every child is protected, every child grows to enjoy their adulthood, to enjoy their life in future, not being, you know, denied an opportunity to grow by some perpetrators of these vices here. So the challenges that we have is that challenge of being somebody to just trust and give you some little resources to start with. For example, we are currently, I told you from the beginning that we now want to move from where we are to come to the community. These are resources. You need some money to pay for the office space. You need some money to run the daily activities. And remember, you're a non-profit making. You're not a limited company. Yeah. So that is one of the challenges. And another challenge that we've had is our vision. You know, we have done so much. So many people are seeing us as now the employer. That when we were looking just for volunteers for our program in Kisumu, we got 218 applications in March this year, just before we closed. And you see, and everybody's in your inbox, Crispin, child space, I need, can I get a job? Can I get an opportunity? Can I do what? Then they think because we are doing these things, we have the money. We don't have the money. That is a challenge. I think it's how we've been branded, how we are doing our things there. And we are doing all these things because of our commitment. We are working with very dedicated young people, especially those dance trainers, those artists. Actually, let me say it here. Our dance trainer, Winnie, is actually my former mentee. I mentored this child from primary school to high school and to wherever she went, and now she's back to support Child Space Organization. I mentored this other young artist who is now taking part and the charge for our program, the art. His work is not even out. We have so much. We have not shown the world what we've been able to do with these young people, and you will see. And we have social workers who have graduated. These were young people whom I really mentored. They go and they come back. So we need to trust, and they will need for them to be here with us. They also need even some little sort of maybe communication. You want to, you know, be sent somewhere. We need somebody to just look at the Child Space Organization, vet it, ask him if they're going to do anything that you think you need, and we have the best. We have the policies of child protection. We have the policies of any policy that you would want that in relation with what our work are there and actively there, and we are following them. For instance, all children must be safe, and we are saying no child should walk alone. Leave alone, you'll never walk alone. The other one that we say, we're saying no child should walk alone when coming to child space. That is a policy that we developed and improved after the training and the conference by the Keeping Children Safe in the UK. And we said no child should walk alone as a measure of safeguarding, because a lot of defilements and harm happen, especially when children are alone, okay, whether at home or on their roads. So that is one of the I'm just highlighting one of the things that we are doing differently from other people. Yeah.
Okay. So what message do you have for policymakers, now, even for the government?
It is very simple. We try to engage these people. Last week, I was talking with the deputy IG, Inspector General of Police, in a certain platform where we met, and she said, "Madam said, Crispin, you are actually doing an awesome job. So, what I can tell the policymakers, by the way, they have done a good job. To be honest, yeah, we have a lot of policies. Yesterday, we were discussing a certain in ACRU platform. We were discussing or the policies that are the gaps that are there, because the policies are already there. Like I just told you, we have so many policies and so many documents to implement already. But what is missing is the support. Yeah, is the support, the goodwill, so to say. Let me just call it the goodwill. This goodwill to ensure that the already formulated policies are followed up to the latter, to ensure that CSOs, for example, Child Space Organization and other players are able to follow this thing to ensure that they are implemented. It is the role of the government. The other day, I was talking in another platform and I was telling people, do you know even you have the right to food? Okay, mm-hmm. In this country. Yes, we have the right to food. In our constituent 43, I think the article 43 there, we have the right to food and the right to quality food, to access it. So we have so many things that are there in the paper, but people do not know about them. So the policymakers have done their good job. All we need, in March, for example, in March this year, we participated in the national launch of to end teenage pregnancy by the National Council for Population Development, okay, NCPD. We were there and we spoke and the bills were there. You know, they represent the women rep were there. Those who are passionate about this, we confirmed these policies are there, you're okay? So what we need is to let the policymakers realize the policies are there and they're able to hold our hands as people on the ground to actually implement these things and be able to, for instance, how do you say that this year's Day of African Child theme was access to child friendly justice system in Africa, access to a child friendly justice system in Africa? That was the 2020 theme for the Day of African Child. Do we have those systems that are friendly for the children? Do we have those people who are supporting are following up on these things? So that's why I'm saying, we have enough documents, we have enough policies. Kindly let us implement this as we move forward, because we have the people. All we need is the goodwill. You know, we can never say we are interested, and that's why we're not saying we're interested in child space. We're saying we are committed to holistic child development. We need people who are committed to what they say, to what they do, and to what they're actually promising the country. That's exactly what I can say. Yeah.
Oh, all right. So what are your last sentiments to the viewer?
Wow. Every child should be given an opportunity. Every child should be given an opportunity to grow. Every child should be given a platform to be heard. Every child should be given an opportunity to go to school and access even those which we as maybe adults did not even access. Support them, work with them. Don't just overreact to a child. Every child, whether mine biological or not, support the children just like the same way we were supported when we were growing up. Not all of us got what we wanted from these significant adults, but we can start over again and have that life of the children, the children having life that they aspire to be. Because if you ask any child today, what do you want to be when you grow up? I want to be like so-and-so. Is there a child that want to be like Crispin Okello when they grow up? I have so many. How many do you have, Violet? How many do all these viewers have? Not a child looking at you and they see a beast. They see somebody that should run away from. They see somebody who is like an animal. No, we are not saying give them money. All we are saying is please behave well. Be the mirror to these children. That's all I can say.
Thank you so much, Crispin, for your participating in this live show. And thank you even for the words of encouragement and even reaching out even to various stakeholders even through this discussion. So, viewer, I want to say thank you for joining us. And thank you again, Crispin. And join us soon, even as we even have the next guest on this particular platform. So he'll be from Uganda. And he's going to share about what he's doing on the ground. So thank you, Crispin, and thank you, viewer. Enjoy your day.